Hey guys, Will Walker, Comlax.com, here with Pat Giganti, owner, head strength conditioning coach here at Accelerated Performance, and we're going to go over a couple things about training in the off season, some things that he sees that some people doing and aren't doing, and we're going to go into that a little bit with you. So, Pat, like, how are you doing today?
Wonderful. I'm happy you guys are here.
Yeah, thank you for having us. So a couple things. You have a couple different sports coming in here. Lacrosse, hockey.
Well, we have everything. Lacrosse, yep. Hockey, baseball, football, all your women's sports, volleyball, all the way down to squash.
Okay.
So, you know, we just keep the athletes going.
Nice. So Comlax, obviously we're lacrosse. So you got some of those guys coming in here. What are some things you see that people are doing?
Oh, see a lot of guys overdoing. You know, especially in our lacrosse, you know, a lot of conditioning, not enough stretching. I see a lot of guys doing a lot of conditioning and speed drills because that's the game.
Yep.
You know, without their lacrosse stick or gloves. You know, we can make anybody stronger and faster, but you know, lacrosse is a big skill sport, so we also should be focusing in on skill because we want what we do in, you know, the weight room or on the track or on the field, you know, to always correlate to the sport.
Okay.
So a couple of tips that we'll show you guys today will be, you know, a lot of speed drills that you've probably seen before, but now we're going to take our lacrosse stick and we're going to put a ball and we're going to add it into to what you're doing, because that's what correlates onto the field. We always want to make, you know, our time valuable. We want to work smart and not just hard. That's a key.
Sure. Will's going to do some demonstrating. As I said before, it's extremely important to understand that you're never going to play the game of lacrosse without a stick.
Can't.
So, like I said, a lot of times we make the mistake of doing all our speed drills, all our quick feet drills, which we have here, our ladder, without a lacrosse stick. The key to this, well, is the toughest thing for an athlete, okay, especially an athlete, you know, with the lacrosse stick, is to have our upper and lower body work together. Having your upper and lower body work together generates speed, generates power. That's what we want, okay? We're gonna show you a drill right now where it's called the Icky Shuffle. We wanna go 1 foot in, 2 feet in, 1 foot out. But now we have a lacrosse stick, okay? When we lead with our right, the lacrosse stick's here. As soon as we get here to our left, we want the lacrosse stick to come out, okay? And switch sides. So it's here, boom, boom, okay? While we're going. The other thing is that I see with my lacrosse athletes is they're dominant to one side, okay? Whatever you do first gets the most results. So which way do you throw better? Which way do you cradle better?
I throw with my right hand.
Throw with your right hand. Well, one of the things I'd like to see my righties do is starting on their left side. If you can have both sides of your body working well, think about how much better you will play. All right, let's give this a shot. Here we go. See him switching hands. Keep that head up. Peek down for a sec. Use your peripheral vision. Good, excellent. And that's an Icky Shuffle. Again, like I emphasized, we always have a weaker side. In any sport that we play, we have imbalances. We should take ourselves out of our comfort zone.
Okay.
And we know that your left side is not your comfort zone. Although you're pretty good, I'll give you credit, it's not your comfort zone, so that's what we're gonna start with. Now, it's a simple drill, okay? We're gonna go 2 feet in each. You're starting with your left side, you're cradling with your left side. I want your left foot to go first in the ladder every time. If your brain's telling your feet what to do, okay? And your brain is also telling your upper body what to do at a quicker pace, and you can get it right and you can be smooth. When you transition onto the field, you will be that much faster and you will have that much more edge over your opponent. So we're here, we're gonna take left foot first, 2 feet in each, cradling, okay? Then we're gonna come back right foot first,
okay.
All right? Now guys, the key to this is we wanna get it right, okay? If you do something 1,000 miles an hour wrong, it's still wrong. So slow it down at the beginning, get every step right, and then you'll see within a week or so, your progression will be phenomenal. Go ahead, let's see it. Excellent, excellent. Here we go, now we're going to the comfort zone. Perfect, great job, Mr. Walker.